Today, and we're grateful that you all took the time out to take part in this event for us.
Thank you, God. Good afternoon, political figures, community partners, media, friends, and all of our awesome co-workers. My name is Jason Watson, and I'm the shop chairman of UAW Local 2164. It is an honor to have each of you with us today for this event. Very exciting day, it's a very exciting moment. So I hope y'all will be glad to share this with us here momentarily when we have some words.
Okay. Today we're incredibly privileged to have the CEO and chairwoman of General Motors with us. That's Mary Vera. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce Mary for a few words.
Well, it is really exciting to be in Bowling Green, and it's been a privilege to meet some of you in the Diet with Slice meeting we had, some of on the plant tour, and most of all, everybody in the room. It's been so exciting. Thank you all for being here. Thanks for your enthusiasm and thanks for your commitment. As Jason said, we also have some very special guests here, and I want to make sure we welcome them. So first, Jason is really not a guest. He is part of the leadership team along with Kai, but also UAW Regional Representative Tim Smith. Governor Matt Bevins. U.S. Senator Rand Paul. Congressman Brett Gundry. Warren County Judge and Executive Mike Buchanan. Mayor Bruce Wilkerson. United Way of Southern Kentucky, Bowling Green Boys and Girls Club, Friends of Lost River, and the Warren County Stormwater. So thank you all as well. Today, I am really honored to make a very important and exciting announcement for Bowling Green. And I want to make sure everybody understands, this announcement continues to be something I want to be clear about. General Motors is absolutely committed to investing in and growing good-paying manufacturing jobs in the United States. Jobs that strengthen, thank you. We want to create jobs that not only strengthen us today, but position us for a very strong future. So I am exceptionally pleased to announce that this morning, this afternoon, that we will be adding a second shift and more than 400 hourly jobs at Bowling Green to support the next generation of the Corvette, or as we like to call it, the C8, and increase the plant's workforce to more than 1,300 employees. Facilities in all of the United States. So again, thank you for your commitment to safety. customer is one of the most specific and understands and knows every inch of their vehicle. And so another honor that the Bowling Green team has is the highest paint quality of any of General Motors facilities in the world. And again, that's something they work hard at every day. So let's congratulate them. Dozens and hundreds and probably close to millions custom Corvette enthusiasts around the world. This workforce, these men and women, are teaming up to deliver one of the most important tasks we have, of delivering the most beloved vehicle out there, America's sports car. Now, for years, there has been rumors about the next generation Corvette. And I've had the difficult task, as I know many of the members of the Bowling Grand team of, is when people start to ask you, tell me about the next generation Corvette. For the longest time, I couldn't even admit that it existed. So I have to say, I'm sorry, I'm not allowed to discuss future product programs. Well, just a couple of weeks ago, we had the thrill of being in New York City, and I know many of you know, Taj Junker, who is our executive chief engineer, he drove and I got to ride in the Corvette as we went through Times Square. Now, we were driving a camo C8, but I have to tell you, the responses that we got from people who got that first glimpse was just amazing. New Yorkers literally stopped in their tracks, turned their heads, pulled out their phones, snapped pictures, and it really, and you saw it moments after starting to light up the internet. It was incredible to watch, and I don't need a reminder to reinforce that why this car is so special, because it truly is an American icon, and it's an American icon for a reason. It's got history, it's true Chevrolet, it really delivers incredible value, and it makes it attainable when you compare it to cars that perform at the same level. So we are super proud of Corvette, we're super proud of the fact that it is truly an American icon. Today's announcements follow several other positive announcements we've made recently. Separate to our announcement today, just last month at our Lake Orion facility in Michigan, we announced an investment of $300 million in the addition of 400 jobs to produce an all-new Chevrolet all-electric vehicle. We'll announce additional investments throughout the year, and all of those will come with new jobs. But however, I think we need to step back and remember, General Motors has been investing in the United States for more than 100 years. In the past decade alone, General Motors has invested more than $22 billion in our facilities in 11 states. That accounts for over 26% of all U.S. auto manufacturing investments in that time frame. And these investments support more than 4,600 manufacturing employees, plus 4,000 dealers across the nation. The investments also support more than $50 billion that we spend annually with our suppliers in this country. Now, when you look at General Motors and where we're headed, about 18 months ago, we announced a new vision to create a world with zero crashes, zero emissions, and zero congestion. And then we took it a step forward further, and we said, we are committed to an all-electric future. And that took some people by surprise, because does that mean we're going to stop producing trucks or SUVs, or for this location, worst of all, Corvettes? And I can tell you, it absolutely does not mean that. It's a vision that we won't deliver overnight, but it's an ambitious vision we have set for ourselves because we at General Motors know we have the team, the technology, and the talent to get this done. And every new vehicle we launch has more safety features on that road to a zero crash future. Every vehicle we launch is more fuel efficient, is lighter, has more performance on our way to that zero emission vision. And then, of course, when technologies work together, we do believe we can dramatically reduce congestion. So I want you all to know you are very much a part of the journey that we have in front of us to create this world where not only do we give people freedom and mobility, but we also solve some of the issues that have happened over the course of 100 years. I have to tell you, as we rolled out this vision, I have seen firsthand as how it has energized the company, and it is driving every business decision we make. We're in an industry that is facing tremendous disruption, but I like to see it as opportunity and truly a transformation that we can lead. I know we have the foundation, I know we have the plan, and I know we have the talent to lead in this transformation and to truly win. We will continue to invest in our core products because they are important to our customers, they're a key part of our business strategy, and they will be for many years to come. So I'd like to close by reiterating, General Motors is committed to supporting U.S. manufacturing and growing jobs in the United States. I'm sorry I couldn't hear you, but I'll talk to you after. Bowling Green Assembly has produced over 1 million Corvettes since it opened in 1981, and we hope we are here for many decades to come and build many more vehicles into the future. So I want to thank everyone here, the GM team members, the UAW, all of our stakeholders. Your dedication to our customers and to General Motors and to the future we will build together is what makes all of this possible. So now I will turn it back to Kai.
Hi, I'm Lily, and you're watching the Corvette Channel. Don't forget to hit subscribe.